Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and welcome back to more RFL. Last time we beat up some enemies, got through part of the prologue, and we still have a bit of the prologue to go through. We are at a point of no return, which means once we go through this, everything before this will be blocked off. So if you haven't collected everything, best be now to check everything. You may never know if you find something useful or something worthwhile, but let us proceed. I believe we have everything. Wow, this is pretty incredible. There's hardly any tarnish on it. Do you think it's elven? Beats me, probably. I've explored some elven ruins before, though, and I've never seen anything like this. If I was going to hide a magic ring, it'd be in a place like this, but I don't see anywhere it could be. What was that? Ah! Adrian! Lena, what happened? Something opened up under my feet! I'm losing my grip! Adrian, I'm gonna fall! Take my hand! Lena, no! Well, looks like Adrian failed his detect trap skill. See, I would have detect trap skills, so that way I would be able to see whether there would be a trap around here. But now he's lost his party member. But we are the one playing Lita. I mean, I believe Lita is our main character anyways. Ow! Well, I don't think I'm hurt. Ah. How far did I fall? I can't even see the hole I fell in up here. Hey, Adrian? Adrian! Oh, this is just perfect. I guess I better see if there's a way out of here. Yeah, that's... It's just one floating island. Or one floating mass. One fall, and it's over. If there's anything about it, anyways. Now, what do we have here? Eh, skeleton. I can barely see it, but it looks like there's a note carved into the floor here. I wonder if I can make out what it says. Turn back. Yeah, great idea, skeleton. Thanks for the heads up. Turn back, huh? That sounded like it came from outside. Turn back from what? Well, either way, a path is open. We might as well see what... Yep. Now we have more to explore. There is the ghost again. It's that ghost lady again. Dot dot dot. Who are you? You look pretty. Hello. Can you help me? I fell down here and I don't know how to get out. 3 times 3 equals 9. What was that all about? There's so many people with the dot 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 that I might as well just put some random words in their mouths. Cause why not? They're doing the whole dot 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 thing, so I might as well make use of it. 31 coins! Yay! Now I can get myself that new dress! I don't know how much dresses cost in this world, but maybe there's enough for her to get a new dress. Probably one with some shorts. Ooh, what do we have here? Huh, it's a little ring. Could this be what Adrian came here to find? I wonder if I should take it. Yep, might as well. So much trouble for this dumb thing. It's kind of pretty, I guess. Wow, I can feel magic flowing into me. Whatever that sound is, it's really starting to weird me out. I mean, it's not Excalibur. Another secret door opening? Suspiciously right after I took this ring. Well, I guess I don't exactly have anywhere else to go. Might as well check it out. There could be loot. There's nothing else we can do. Explore for a way out. Hope we find some useful loot. Or something to that caliber. Now, this is a pretty deep hole. Should I climb into it? Yep. Ow. Oh no, I'm here again. I really thought that was going to be the way out. Oh goddess, I'm gonna die in here, aren't I? Not if you learn how to forge some food and learn how to clear some rubble, you might be able to find a way out. Oh, I'm exhausted. I guess I'll keep looking for a way out in the morning. I do like the change in facial expressions. It's just kind of nice. You are the chosen one. That morning. Looks like the girl is well enough. Some bumps and bruises, but I imagine she'll need a good drink of water. She's only sleeping, though, and rather soundly, I might add. I see. Well, you have my sincerest gratitude for rescuing my daughter. I'll see to a reward for this. Don't trouble yourself with that. You may want to tell your daughter to be more careful, though. Indeed. I'll see to it that she is appropriately reprimanded. Master Lakota, I'm really sorry this happened. And I'm sure you are. Now be quiet and stay away from my daughter from now on. Am I understood? Yes, sir. Now then, let's get her home.
You're from Meloria, I take it. Just so happens I've got a wagon of goods headed there for the market. I'll travel there with you. Put the girl in the back of the cart, let her sleep with the vegetables for a bit.
And I'm twice in your debt, Raymer. I thank you again.
I've got a feeling it'll be repaying one way or another. That girl owes me a favor. Even at that for now. Come on, I want to get to Aloria while the morning is still young.
So she has a favor with him. Well, I'm gonna wonder how that's gonna all turn out.
So you're an adventurer, right, boy?
Me? Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Is that how you make your living? Dangerous work. You never know what sort of evil things lurk in the dark.
Yeah, well, fishing's all I'm good at, so it's this or being a guard at Casa Atana. Ruins are more interesting, and besides, somebody has to face off against those evil things, right?
Aye, boy, I reckon somebody does.
There's no reason that someone has to be my little girl. Yeah, I think she's gonna be the one who's gonna face all the evil. Sorry to break that bubble.
We're nearly to Aloria. Is the girl still asleep?
She is. She must have been quite exhausted for the bumpy ride not to have awoken her.
An evening of spelunking will do that to you.
wasn't there an archery competition later today? I heard the girl was competing in it.
And she is, if she can drag herself out of bed to compete in it, and I decide to allow it after this nonsense.
Well, here we are, and not too late in the morning here either. Looks like your daughter slept right through it.
Without your help, she might have still been trapped in there. I thank you again, Reamer. Happy to do it, stranger.
Alright, I want to get these vegetables to market before they get slept on some more.
Help me bring Lynn inside, and then leave my home. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Off we go, then. And if you'll pardon my being forward, I don't think you should go too rough on your daughter. There's a lot to see in the world. It's hard to resist. All right, then. To the bazaar. Maybe I should get some of that rhubarb.
Chapter 1. We're finally out of the prologue, prelude, whatever you want to call it, before the first chapter. Chapter 0. Yes. Morning already? I hate that stupid bell. Wait, where am I? Back home? Was that all a dream?
I see you're awake. No, it was not a dream. Some dwarven strangers and I rescued you from that hole.
Oh, good morning, Papa. Listen, I'm really sorry about that.
I'm not interested in your excuses, child. You could have been hurt or even killed, Ada, and I'm rapidly losing my patience with your reckless behavior.
I know, but I was really careful this time. It's not my fault a trapdoor opened up under my feet. The treasures we were looking for is really important, so...
Important treasure? And that was reason enough to put yourself in such danger? Again? What would your mother do if we lost you? Have you ever thought about that?
What would I do? Your brother, your friends, all this nonsense just to find some trinket that you didn't even manage to locate. Well, I did find it. It doesn't seem to be very magical, though.
And on the evening of your archery contest, you should have been resting last night and practicing today. I had intended to take you on your first hunt after the competition as a reward for all your hard work recently. Well, you can forget about that, and I have half a mind to bar you from the competition as well.
Papa, no, come on. I've been looking forward to going hunting since forever.
You should have thought of that before I was dragged to Silvara in the dead of night to pull you out of a hole.
That was an accident.
I know it was an accident. It's always an accident with you.
Hey, I'm sorry I fell into the stupid hole. But I'm not sorry for not wanting to be trapped in Aloria. I don't want to spend the rest of my life picking apples and feeding chickens. Goddess, you sound just like your mother. What was that?
Nothing, dear.
That man is impossible. All right, calm down, Lena. He's a jerk, but it's not like he doesn't have a point. I've gotten into trouble a lot lately. I should go find Papa and apologize.
Save your game? Yes. How many save slots do I have?
15 slots.
So I will just use all the slots I have, so that way if something goes wrong, I can go back and re-record. More coins! Nothing here. Long, long ago, Arafel was once part of the underworld. That world's true name has been lost to the ages, and has come to be known as the Abyss, the world of the dead. There are many gods that had claimed kingdoms as their own in the Abyss. Since the dawn of time, gods coveted the lands and wealth of one another. Small skirmishes often erupted between them. In time, a great war began between the gods for control of the Abyss. All the gods fought except the goddess of the sun,
who lifted Arafel into the sky to protect her children from the war. Oh really? It starts playing, and then it just cuts. I mean, I understand that there really is a limitation, but good heavens. You should really try and make it seamless. Maybe that's how they intended. Maybe that's not. I don't know. It feels like to me it needed a little bit more polish. All the gods died and all of their kingdoms were destroyed. Only the kingdom of Arafel survived. The goddess granted her people with a gift to protect them. The Sunstone. Oh no, not the Sunstone. Okay guys, we need to protect that Sunstone from a couple of kids and one with red hair. If he gets it, I don't know what's gonna happen. Maybe Arafel will be pretty much messed up afterwards. Believing the god's power only brought corruption. She disappeared into the sky to join with the sun, so that light would always shine in Arafel. On that day, the abyss became the land of the dead.
Good lore. There's a map, which we can't take. Is there anything else we can, find, collect, whatever?
Nope. That seems to be it.
Papa isn't here. I wonder where he went. Well, I should probably say good morning to Mom before I go. I think there are some potions in the chest around here somewhere, and I'll take an apple for breakfast.
An apple for breakfast?
Now, this isn't exactly what I call a wholesome breakfast, but it's better than nothing, I guess. Morning, Mom. Where did Papa say he was going? He didn't, but I imagine he went out to Ceramy Plains to help set up the archery contest. He looked pretty angry. Did I hear him complaining about me up there? Well, he said I sounded like you, if you want to call that complaining. I was something of an adventurer when I was your age, you know. That was when your father and I first met. He didn't care for it then, and he doesn't want to see you go down the same path. And seeing how small you are, he's probably a little overprotective. I'm not that small, and I'm 16. I can take care of myself. I know you can, sweetheart, but there's a subtle difference between bravery and foolishness. You have to admit, there's a line you cross sometimes. I guess that's true. I'll try to be more careful. Anyway, I better go find Papa so I can apologize. Actually, you may want to speak to that boy first. You know, that cute blonde one you have such a crush on. What's his name again? Excuse me, I don't have a crush on anybody. Adrian, that's it. Your father was a little, brusque with... Brusque? Brusque? Brusque with him this morning. I don't know how that's pronounced. If anyone knows, feel free to let me know. He's all but forbade him from seeing you again. I don't think Adrian is a bad person, though, and your father will calm down eventually. You should talk to Adrian. I believe he's at the temple on the northeast side of town. Yeah, that's a good idea. Maybe I will. Good. Now, one last thing before you go, Lita. I want you to be home before dark. Vampires have been attacking people more often than usual lately. I mean it this time, young lady. I don't mind you adventuring like your father does, but I want you to do it when the sun is overhead. Understand? Yes, ma'am. I will. I promise. Good. I love you, sweetheart. Good luck in the archery competition. Your father and I will both be there. Thanks, Mom. Bye.
So, vampires. That does not sound good. I can take one if I like. Some items have special effects that you wouldn't expect. For example, apples will increase your maximum HP by 5 permanently.
I shouldn't eat too many apples. I'll end up getting, like, apple poisoning or something.
Apple poisoning? I don't think there's a such thing as apple poisoning. Do you have a bit of an aversion to apples?
Hey, sis! What did he do to Papa? He stormed out of here like he was ready to punch somebody in the nose. I sassed him when he scolded me for going out adventuring last night. Oh yeah, he did have that Nita just sassed me look on his face.
Is it me, or is he trying to clean the carpet with a rag? I mean, it could be that he is playing with a toy, but dang, it looks like he's just trying to clean a carpet. And really, is that how you clean a carpet? That's not exactly what I call a way to clean it. The temple is this way. Mom's right. I really ought to talk to Adrien after last night. Especially since I found his ring.
His ring!
Need some coins? Come to our Rangers Guild in Aloria and speak to the fortune and seek your fortune.
Fortune?
And seek your fortune hunting bounties. Traveling merchant, huh? I'm gonna be seeing this one.
Female, so. Okay, we'll just go with the generic.
Hello, I'm Talani the Traveling Merchant. I've seen every corner of Irafel in my travels. Have you seen the Sunstone lately? I hope it's not stolen by some kid named Chrono. If you want to see something really neat, though, you should find one of the big crystals hiding around Irafel. They have a secret. There's one in the Great Bazaar just across the bridge to the south. Anyway, do you need anything? I can reset my level here. Medicine and equipment. What do you have for equipment, huh?
Bow plus two.
Is that what?
It's going all Dungeons and Dragons on me. Would you like a bow?
Yes.
Would you like a bow plus two?
No, I kind of want a bow plus one. Plus two seems too plus two.
Ah, how about a plus three then?
Plus three bow. I don't know if I would be able to defeat any enemies with it.
Ah, then you need a plus four bow.
But what about the apples? If I shoot one, it's gonna blow up.
Then you need a 3.5 bow.
Oh.
I want agility, specifically. Archer's bracer, shield, she can't wear it, so she might as well get that. Headband. Just give her all the agility. I've got enough medication, I believe I've got all the artifact of power. And it looks like it's stuck to her. Well, maybe they should have left an instruction on it saying, do not put on the ring. Oh well. Let's check out the bazaar, huh? And all these unique characters. I think all these characters are visually... Yeah, I think almost all of the... I think these characters are sort of unique. King Aragorn has fallen terribly ill recently. I hope he's okay. It's probably a bout of diarrhea. Hello there, Lita. Say, can you do me a little favor?
Sure.
Sure, what do you need?
Thank you. Old man Ricker has been worse than usual lately. I have a note for him that might cheer him up. Would you mind taking it to him for me? He should be northeast of here, near Shelley's home.
No problem, Miss L. So we need to take a note to an old man that should cheer him up. I'll be off to the hunting grounds soon. You can make a few coins if you sell stardust crystals and herbs. Gotta watch out though, stay out past sundown and you'll stop being the predator and start being the prey.
Is there some way to know the time? Let's see, what do we have in here? King Aragorn's advisor, Lady Miranda, is ruling Castle Atana temporarily. She seemed strange lately.
Strange? Must be going through that point, period.
No, not that period. Good heavens.
No.
Oh, jeez, it's the same. It's the same thing. Is that all they have for books? Come on, that's boring. If I could just finish these maps. Hey, you have a pretty good map, don't you, Lena? I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have any map. As far as I know, anyways. Teleport crystals and Lena's approximate location will be displayed. Press the shift key or the Y button to switch between maps. Press the back button to exit. The main quest is indicated with a red exclamation point. Keep in mind that you may need to switch maps to see it. Side quests are not shown. Use quest items for directions. There's a lot of bridges, that's for sure. Talani's shop, hunting range, Holy Land, North Starway, farmland. Oh, then there's more. How big is this map, huh? So there's, I guess there's a northern half and a southern half? Looks like the southern half's a lot colder though. Just smell that fresh morning air, Lena. Perhaps we can go back to your room and enjoy it. Okay, for one thing you're a creep, for another I'm pretty sure that doesn't even make sense. Hey baby, when you look this good, it doesn't have to. Oh great. We have a pompous jerk. Sheesh. What about these two, huh? Hey lady, you figured out how to talk to me. Aren't you clever? Here, have this thing. Earthstone. Well, I figured out how to talk to you because there was a nice sparkly next to the river. So there's that. Look, I'm a sea monster. Well, a river monster anyway. A creek monster, I guess? Look, just leave me alone. Just don't fall off the waterfall, huh? Don't know how your parents would take it if you were to decide to fall off a waterfall. Ooh, a basket of apples. I kind of saw a small glimmer and bam, free apple. The statue here has been here for a long time. Someone told me it used to be alive. This looks like a very lifelike statue of somebody. You know, funny thing is that if it really looks lifelike, why hasn't it been worn away through the sands of time or erosion, so to speak? It's possible that they left it inside throughout all this time. There might have been a sign that says, "Please do not put me outside. For the love of all that is great and beautiful, please do not put me outside. Seriously, my face will weather away and I will die." It's kind of a long sign, but hey, it'll get someone's attention. Oh, hello, sweetie. If you're looking for armor, check the back room. Well, I'm not exactly looking for armor. I already have all the armor I'm looking for. Crystal, stardust, herb, essence. Well, looks like there's, well, they're in good supply, so I'm not gonna worry about that. Potions. Cures all status ailments. Restores 10% magic. Cup of Dreams. 500 coins for a revival item. Well, makes sense. Hello, Lena. Hello there, Lena. The bazaar certainly is bustling today, isn't it? So it seems to be. Look at all the goodies. Ooh, look at all the goodies indeed. I hope she's not looking at the cookies. Because there's no cookies. Good luck in the archery contest, Lena. Everyone's rooting for you. You've unlocked the Aloria teleport.
This must be one of the big crystals that strange merchant lady was talking about.
Woo! 2,000 XP just for touching a crystal! If only I could get that experience for touching a crystal! All I get are just jobs. I touch a crystal and it gives me the ability to become a thief, a knight. Oh, white mage, black mage, why can't I just get some experience, huh?
Maybe those jobs are actually much more better than experience, but then again, I don't think there's any jump classes in this game, so... This magical crystal will let you travel long distance instantly, provided you have discovered another crystal to make a connection with.
Oh. That's right, you need to make a connection with another crystal. You have to make sure that you've connected this one to another one, and through a series of magical land cables, it will teleport you to wherever you want to go. And it probably lets you teleport wherever you want to go even without the need to, well, be near a crystal. Explore the world to find all of them. The locations that are lit up here are the ones you have found already.
Well, it kind of looks lit up now.
Lady Lakata, the finest archer this side of Dian Scully. How are you, girl?
I'm fine.
Listen to me. There's talk of vampires and other creatures coming out of the blood forest at night. You be careful if you ever head that way. The best archer that ever lived will still be eaten alive by those things.
Well, I won't be in the forest at night then.
Hey there, I sell toys. Like this cute stuffed snow bear. They're 12 coins. Want one?
You may never know.
Great, here you go.
You may never know if you might need a stuffed bear.
The Great Bazaar is the biggest collection of shops on all of RFL.
Well, it looks like it's a great bazaar
It really does look like a great bazaar, to be honest. Although, it kind of looks... slightly understocked.
Hello there, young lady. I'm selling flour, breads, and cakes priced at 4, 5, and 100 coins, respectively.
Well, I'll get some... flour.
You'll find no finer flour in all of RFL, I assure you.
And here's a smithy. And it looks like they do tailoring jobs too.
Sorry, kid, I can't talk right now. Lady Miranda has ordered 100 swords for her army.
100 swords? I wonder how long that'll take to get finished.
Oh, Lena, good to see ya. Say, you're old enough to swing a hammer now, aren't you? If you've got 500 coins, I'll teach you how to do it.
Well, I don't have that much money on me. 500 coins. I would have to go out on a fighting spree for that.
In any case, we are pretty much past my cutoff point, so I am going to save the game right here, and I will see you all next time on the playthrough of RFL. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment down below, follow me on Twitter and or Tumblr, and support me on Patreon if you want to. I do, however, appreciate it a whole lot. Thank you. You all have a wonderful day. I am Melcadrien. I am signing off. Happy gaming!